Welcome back everyone to the video lecture series on flexible bodies. For the sake of convenience, I have merged the third and the fourth video together so that the full exercise demo is covered in one video only. So now, let me begin with the exercise demo. So click on the flex tools option and then the flex prep option to invoke the flex prep dialog box. Now, you can leave the first option as it is because we are creating the opdestruct PRP file and we're also generating the H3D flex body file. So we'll keep the first option as it is. Next, we need to load the .fem file, that is the FEA file that we want to convert into the flex body. So let's load our .fem file. So it's in chapter 12. So first, let's work with the left lower control arm. So I'll select this file slaflexleft.fem. So this gets loaded in. Now, let me go to the fourth option. Here, I will be saving the file, my flexbody file, as slaflexleft. I'll call it test1, and the file extension will be .h3d. So then I hit save. So I want to keep the component mode synthesis method as Craig Bampton method, and then for the next option I want to specify the interface nodes. So for my model, the interface nodes are 4887, and if you can remember, I had mentioned that we need to separate the interface nodes with the plus symbol. So I'll be separating the interface nodes with the plus symbol. So the first interface node is 4887, the second one is 4888, and the next one is 4890. And the next option, which is the cutoff type and the value, I'll leave it as it is. Okay, so this is the maximum modes requested by the user, so I leave this as 15. And by default, the solver mode is Lanczos, and I will leave the rest of the options as it is. So I'll go to the additional options, and I will check on the perform stress recovery and also the perform strain recovery options in order to get the stress and strain results for the body. Then I close this. Now, I hope you all remember what I told you in the previous video. We need to convert all the RBE3 spiders into RBE2 spiders. So let me just click on this particular option which says create RBE2 spiders. So when you click this, hypermesh will be invoked on the fly. Okay, so we can see that happening now. Let's give it some time. Yes, so it took you directly to the hypermesh GUI. Okay, so first thing what we need to do here is go to this particular option which says user profile. Okay, and we need to select this as opdestruct and say okay. So once we do that, and now if we zoom in, we can see that this is RBE2 spider. So no problem with that. Now we need to create an RBE2 spider here. So we come here and click on the utility tab and then the user tab here. So and then click on the super spider and select one of the nodes here and say proceed. So automatically we get a RBE2 spider that's created at this particular interface node. Next, we need to convert if these two spiders are not RBE2 spiders, then we need to convert them into RBE2 spiders. So let's check what the spiders are. So let's go to the card edit and then change this particular option to elements. and then select these elements. Say edit. So what does it say? RBE3 here. So these are the spider is basically it's an RBE3 spider. Okay. So we need to convert this to RBE2. Now let me check with the other spider that we have here. So again, go to the same option, card edit. Click on these elements, say edit. These are RBE2. So this is all fine. So what we need to do is we need to convert these elements from RBE3 to RBE2 before doing anything with our flex body. Okay. So still keep in mind, this is not a flex body. It's just the OptiStruct file. It's a .fem file. And once we run our flex prep utility, we'll be getting the .h3d file. So this is just the pre-processing part of it. Okay. Now I'll be converting the RBE3 spider into RBE2 spider. So please concentrate on how I do that. So click on the 1D option here. Okay. The 1D radio button basically. Now you can go to config edit option here and select these elements. And then click on new config and select rigid link as the option. And then you can hit on switch button. So this means that the RBE3 spider has been converted to RBE2 spider. Now you return and you can check that. So go to the same option, which is the card edit option here, and click on the spider and then say edit. So you can see that it is converted to the RBE2 spider. So now we're all set. So once this is done, you can just say save and close. So you can save this particular file as capital SLA flex left test1.fem. Okay. So yeah, it will be saving it in .fem format itself. So no need to worry about that. Okay. So once it gets saved, I think you guys observe that it directly came back to motion view. Okay. So now that's done. So now we should continue with the process to build our flexible body. So I'm just checking once again if the additional options, these two options are checked. And yes, these two options are checked to perform stress recovery and also the strain recovery. Okay, now let's close this and say okay. So OptiStruct runs in the background to generate the flexible body. Okay, so it generates this particular report, which means that, and it says end of report, and we don't see any errors. So it has successfully completed converting the .fem file to the .h3d file, which is nothing but converting the FE model into the flex body. Say okay. Now what you can do is just switch to hyperview. So if you want to just take a look at the flex body, just click on hyperview and load that model. Okay, so this is the SLA flex left test1.h3d. So you've loaded the model and these are the interface nodes that you can see on the screen. Okay, and now let me just do a contour plot. So here we have displacement, stress and strain. Okay, so let me just select displacement and say apply. And here are the different modes and the frequencies. So let me just select a particular mode. And I will set this particular option to set modal animation. And then click play. So I'm just reducing the speed of the animation. So you can see that the maximum displacement at this particular frequency happens in this region. Okay. So this is your flexible lower control arm, and this is on the left hand side of suspension. Okay. Now let's just go back to motion view. Okay, so now we've generated the left lower control arm. So now what we have to do is we need to again use the flex prep utility to basically mirror the left lower control arm and generate the right lower control arm. So for that, we need to select the second option or the second radio button, which says translation of flexible body files. So here, select the second option, which says mirror existing H3D flex body. And then here you need to specify the original H3D file. So you need to click on the folder option here, and then go back to the same location. Okay, so we have our first flexible body file here, which is on the left hand side of suspension. So we take this as the original file, say open, and then specify the mirrored H3D file name. So the one you want to mirror it as. So we need to change from left to right, right? So just click on this particular option, select the same file, but make sure that you change from left to right. Okay, then hit save, and you will be mirroring it across the XZ plane. Okay, and then say okay, and it's done. So instead of again creating the whole flex body for the right lower control arm, this is how simple it is in motion view using the flex prep utility. You have the left lower control arm, you just have to mirror it across a particular plane, which is the XZ plane in this case, to get the right lower control arm. And now say okay. And now what we'll do is we'll just go to the model option here, assembly wizard. So this I'm doing to get the suspension system, the built-in suspension system that's available in motion view library. So first I will load in that, and it has a rigid lower control arms. So I'll be loading in this particular model. So I'll be selecting the front end only, then hit on next option, and then say no driveline, select next. Here I'll be changing the suspension system to front SLA suspension one piece LCA. So make sure you change from the default MacPherson suspension to the third option here. Okay, then click on next, again next. So you can leave these options as it is, and then again click on next. So here leave the compliant option as yes, and then say finish. So you got this suspension system from the motion view model library. Okay, and you can see that, so these are the lower control arms, the red bars that you can see, these are the lower control arms. Okay, and these are now rigid bodies. Okay, they're modeled as rigid bodies. So what we'll be doing is, we already have a flexible body files, so we'll be replacing these rigid body files with the flexible body, and then we'll be running our analysis. Okay, and the analysis that we'll be running will be a static ride analysis. So go to the analysis option, select the task wizard, and here for the task or the type of analysis, we'll be selecting the static ride analysis, say next, and then finish. So you can leave all these parameters as it is. Next, finish. Okay, so you got this particular test rig for the static ride analysis. Now your only job is to replace these rigid lower control arms with the flexible lower control arms that you just created. Okay, so for that, you can just expand the front SLA suspension, this particular model, expand that, and under that you can expand the bodies, and under the bodies you can go to lower control arm. So this highlights the lower control arms. Now what you can do is, it's already in properties, uncheck the symmetric properties and you get this particular dialog box. Okay, so for, when you get this particular dialog box, say retain the values. So just hit on retain. So it retained the values for the left hand side and the right hand side. And now check this flex body option. So it asks you whether you want both the sides to be deformable. So yeah, you want both the left and the right lower control arms to be deformable or flexible bodies. So hit on yes. Okay, so you're on the left hand side now. So you need to basically load in the flexible body file, which is nothing but the .htd file for the left lower control arm. So click on this folder option. So you have these two flex bodies available. So click on the SLA flex left and say open so that it gets loaded in. And once you get this, just click on the notes. Why I do that is because you can see that the model is just brought in. The flex body is just brought in, but it is not connected yet. Okay. So for that, you need to basically put a check mark on this particular option, which says only search for interface nodes. Make sure only this is checked and then hit on find all. Okay. So it finds all the interface nodes and then you can see that it is offset by this distance. So then you can say align all and you'll get a particular warning message saying, are you sure that you want to move the listed entities? Say yes. So when you do that, you can see that, you can close this now. So you can see that it is now perfectly connected to the suspension system. Okay, the left lower control arm. Now I'll be doing the same steps for even the right lower control arm. I'll be switching the tab to the right. I'll be going to the folder option and selecting the SLA flex right test one and say open. So once you get this, go to the notes. Make sure that this is checked. Only search interface nodes and then click on find all. So you can see that it is offset by this distance. So just say align all and then yes for this particular option. So this perfectly goes and connects at the interface nodes with the multibody dynamic system. In this case, it's a suspension system. And one more thing that you got to remember is here, if you click on the left tab, so and go to the modes, so you can see that the first six boxes are left unchecked. So these are the six rigid body modes and we don't want to see any rigid body modes. So hence we're leaving this unchecked. So leave this as it is. And the total number of modes for the flexible body will be equal to 39. Okay. Say close. The same thing even for the right hand side. Okay. So go to the modes. So when you go to the modes, you can see that the first six are the rigid body modes, which are left unchecked. And these are all the flexible body modes, which are all checked. You again have 39 flexible body modes. Okay. Say close. So once this is done, we're all set for analysis. Just click on run. And the simulation type, because it's a static ride analysis, it's a quasi-static analysis. So you can go and click on the folder and you can save your particular file as SLA flex model test1.xml. So save it And the end time, I don't want it to be for 10 seconds, so I'll just reduce it to like 4 seconds. And the print interval, I'll be using 0.01. And you can leave the rest of the options as it is and hit on run. So now, Motion Solve runs in the background. And you can see how fast you get the solution, okay? It's just in a matter of few seconds. So now Motion Solve is running in the background, and this is the message log that you can see. Okay, so yes, it's all done. Say close. I can close for this, and now click on animate. So when you click on animate, hyperview opens in the second window. So now let's go to contour plot and then just select these two components, because we just want the contour plots for these two control arms, right? So we go there, click on components, select the left lower control arm and the right lower control arm. Okay. Then close this and say apply. So you can see the contours now and hit on animate. So now you can see the animation. Okay, so this is basically the result type is displacement. So this is the displacement, and you can see the maximum displacement is at this particular location. Okay, so similarly even here. And because we have checked the perform stress recovery and strain recovery options, it's also calculated the stress and strains. So you can just click on stress and say apply. And you'll get those results. And you can, if you zoom in, you can see that the maximum stress is at around this location. Okay. So, and this is only possible if you use the flex bodies. And we cannot capture this particular deformations in rigid bodies. Okay. So that's the application of the flexible bodies. So yes, we are done with this exercise demo. I can pause it. So one thing I'd like to discuss before I end this particular video is some tips on modeling the flexible bodies. Okay. So the first main thing is to avoid selecting the interface nodes that are very close to each other. So please make sure you do this. Okay. This, if you do, because this increases the likelihood of the modes being almost linearly dependent, and which can cause a difficulty in the convergence of the solution. So make sure that the interface nodes are not too close to each other. The second tip is basically deactivating modes in your flexible body will gain computational speed, but at the same time at the sacrifice of accuracy. So please keep in mind that if you want accurate results, you can keep the flexible body modes, you can keep them all checked. What I mean by this is, let me just go back to the motion view GUI. So I'll just expand this. So here, if I go to the lower control arm, and here if I go to the modes, so make sure that all these options are kept checked. If you uncheck any of these flexible body modes, for sure, the size of your animation file will be reduced, but the results won't be that accurate. Okay. Next, fine mesh is usually not necessary for the component mode synthesis, as only a few fixed interface eigen modes are needed. But most often, people do use a very fine mesh rather than a coarse mesh. So, depending upon your model, you can choose what type of mesh you want. Like, in a sense, the degree of the fineness of the mesh, you can choose depending upon the models you will be simulating. So You can choose fine mesh if you want the stress or strain computed in the body. And also, please use the CBG, that's the Craig-Bampton geometric stiffness method, when the deformations are above the linear range. Okay, so that's brings you to the end of this lecture series on flexible bodies. Thank you.